guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'll be some makeup for today and doing my beautiful study and we're checking out videos together. So say hi. Guys, we're going to be checking out Surah Ar-Rahman, Be Heaven. This was highly recommended and I really want to check it out. Be Heaven. I think I've checked out Surah Maryam. It was very, very nice and so beautiful. But this is going to be interesting, guys. So without further ado, let's get started. I see.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان والأرض وضعها للأنام فيها فاكهة والنخل ذات الأكمام والحب ذو العصف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان خلق الإنسان من صلصال كالفخار وخلق الجان من مارج من نار فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان رب المشرقين ورب المغربين فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يخرج منهما اللؤلؤ والمرجان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان وله الجوار المنشآت في البحر كالأعلام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يسأله من في السماوات والأرض كل يوم هو في شأن فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان سنفرغ لكم أي أمطار السماوات والأرض فانفذوا لا تنفذون إلا بسلطان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يرسل عليكما شواظ من نار ونحاس فلا تنتصران فبأي فإذا انشقت السماء فكانت وردة كالدهان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان فيومئذ لا يسأل عن يعرف المجرمون بسيماهم فيؤخذ بالنواصي والأقدام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان هذه جهنم التي يكذب بها يطوفون بينها وبين حميم آن فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان ولمن خاف مقام ربه جنتان فبأي بطائنها من استبرق وجنى الجنتين دان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان فيهن قاصرات الطرف لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان كأنهم الياقوت والماء مدهامتان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان فيهما عينان نضاختان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان فيهما فاكهة ونخل ورمان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان خيرات حسان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان حور مقصورات في الخيام حور مقصورات في الخيام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان متكئين على رفرف خضر وعبقري حسان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان فبأي تبارك اسم ربك ذي الجلال والإكرام
Wait of God blessings do you deny? What have you done that you're denying? Because talking about mankind and jinn are satans. They're made out of smokeless fire. I think I reacted to a video about jinn a couple of minutes ago. Talking about mankind and jinn, like, what of God's miracles do you deny? Like, why are you not living according to his will? Why are you not living your life according to what he's set for you? Because he has been honest to us from day one. He has been there for us from the beginning. So what do you not believe? What miracle haven't he showed you? What haven't he done to let you know he's the beginning and the end? What haven't he done? So what is making you to disbelieve? There are two seas, but they don't cross paths. He made that. He made you out of clay. So what is making us not believe? What is making us to sin against him? What is making us to go against his will, against what he has set for us? What is making us to do that? Sometimes I just wonder why. Because at the end of the day, we are fully aware the consequences of our action. We fully know where we will go to if we keep denying God, if we keep denying His word, if we keep denying what He said for us, if we don't live according to His will, we know where we will go to. The lake of fire is there. So are we just trying to test God's patience? Are we just trying to see if He actually sent us down there? Or do we not just care? Like, life is just too beautiful to think about tomorrow. Is that what? I'm scared. I'm scared that we'll wake up one day and we'll see that we made a big mistake by not going accordingly to God's word. I'm scared that when we realize what we're doing, maybe a little bit too late and there's no way we can turn back. I'm scared that we'll keep on living this way and we'll forget that God's word is there. God's words never change. But I'm more scared of the way the world is. It makes it difficult for you to want to be righteous. Makes it difficult for you to want to be a saint, because down from the music to the movies to literally everything is just like making you think everything is okay. It's okay to live a certain type of life. It's okay to do this. It's okay to do that. But it's not. And it eats me up every day. Guys, I think we should pray. I think we should take our religion very seriously. I think we should fast. I think we should believe. I think we should come back to God. We should ask for forgiveness. We should not let the human flesh stop us from getting what we're going to get in the end. Because when we die, this flesh will stay here. It's not going to suffer with us. It's just going to deceive us and it's going to stay here on earth. When we're suffering, just going to be our soul. This flesh is not going there with us. So nevertheless, whatever we do, we should think about our future. We should think about when this test ends, what's next, where are we going to? So we need to work hard for it. When you're in school and you know you have a test next week, you prepare. You're serious. When people cheat, they get caught. Either they get out from school, go back to a lower class, or get punished. But why don't we take the test that God has given us seriously? Why don't we prepare for it? Why don't we enter the hall ready? Why do we cheer and be like, God will understand, God will forgive us, He's a merciful Father, He will definitely work way out for us, because He doesn't want us to spend the rest of our life in the lake of fire. But what about us? Can you forgive yourself? If we don't want to spend the rest of our life in lake of fire, why don't you work hard for it? Why don't you stop all the things we're doing? Why don't you just focus on what God has set for us? Why do we keep testing God's faith, keep testing God's will and God's power? I just pray that God forgive us for our sins. I just pray that leads us in the right direction. I pray that we understand our wrongdoing and we come back to God. God, please forgive me for my sins. Forgive me for my shortcomings. Forgive me for the things I've done. Please lead me in the right direction. Lead me in your way. Lead me in your will. Protect me and guide me. Let your will be done in our life. Thank you for everything you've done for us. I thank you for being with me for God. Guys, thank you for recommending this video. I really enjoyed it and it hit me really, really deep. And I'm just praying that God's grace is in our life. I'm just praying that God guide us. I'm just praying that we figure out the right path. The path that we know is the right path, but we are just so blinded by worldly things to follow it. Just pray. We start doing things according to God's will, God's commandment, God's teachings. He sent a lot of prophets down for us, and if that is not enough, what else do we want? Guys, please let me know what you think about my reaction. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and share our videos. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.